Whoa, Stan Lee, comic book genius, master of Marvel, personal friend of mine. It's great to see you, Stan.
Okay, Craig, what do you want?
What? I don't want anything. But since I'm here, I have a great idea for a new superhero.
Yeah, like I've never heard that before.
I know, right. Anyways, you created Spider-Man, the X-Men, Iron Man, and what was the one about that one with all those characters that totally sucked?
Totally sucked? They're the greatest characters of all. What are you talking about?
No, you're wrong. You're wrong, you see, because these characters are weighed down by too much costume. That's where my idea comes in. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Invisible clothes, man.
That doesn't make sense. What are his powers?
Well, his clothes are invisible, so his enemies can't see what he's wearing.
That's it?
And he has a mustache.
A mustache? Mm. Listen, I'm sorry, don't be offended, but it's not for me. It sounds like some kind of a gay fantasy.
Well, maybe if you saw a rough idea of what it would look like.
All right, but I gotta tell you, don't be offended. I don't think it's right for me.
Hey, Craig, is this the part where I come in? My junk is freezing.
What an enormous mustache.
I know, right? I see. I think the kids will like it. And it's cold.
Oh, man.
The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Faster. This Thanksgiving, if you're on his list, then you're already dead. Dwayne Johnson in Faster in theaters November 24th.
But it sounds to me like you might hurt yourself. Please sit down, relax. Whoever's making that whooping sound, shut up. Are you all right? All right. Because I came out and there was a lady in the front row. She was like, oh, oh, oh. We nearly had an adorable yet hilarious incident. It's me, Invisible Clothes Man. I'm in disguise. Hey, it's a great day for America, everybody, yeah? Yes, it is! Yeah, not here in Los Angeles, though, because Travel and Leisure magazine says that LA is one of the worst cities in America. I'm like, how dare you? It says it's one of the worst cities for friendliness and intelligence. And I have two responses to that. One, go to hell. And the other one is, I'm sorry, I completely lost track of what I was talking about. Anyway, you know the police, this is a great story. The police in South Carolina arrested a burglar who was found at a robbery scene, and he was lying face down, naked. This is true. Face down, naked, with a mouse in his rectum. That's the noise I made when I heard about it. I went, oh! I'm like, imagine you were a policeman, you come across here like, oh! It's Invisible Clothes Man and his little accomplice. A mouse in his rectum. Now, I'm not an expert, but it sounds to me like someone slipped him a Mickey. Yeah, all right. Anyway, look. It's a great day, though, if you like Andy Warhol, because yesterday, Andy Warhol's painting of a Coke bottle sold for a record $34 million. Do we have a picture of that? Now, that's a copy of it. If we had the original, I'd be gone. I wouldn't be here. Anyway, it sold for $34 million, and for an extra $10 million, they give you the rest of the word la. As they're supposed to be like that. That's what makes it art. Otherwise, it would just be a commercial. Not that there's anything wrong with commercials. I love commercials. They're my bread and butter. Or who's sponsoring tonight? Probably they're not my bread and butter. They'll be my... My guess is they're my car and boner pills. People say that they buy art like this because it's a great conversation piece, but I'm thinking, well, what kind of conversation is inspired by a 7-foot painting of a Coke bottle? You go... Oh, that's a big Coke bottle there. Yep. Do you have a big painting of a glass with some ice? You know, Andy Warhol painted pictures of soup cans that sell for millions, which I think must really piss off the guy who painted the actual cans. He's like, I painted this for Campbell's for a 20 lousy bucks. Look at this. That's all right. He was some kind of pretend Italian painter.
That's my Fugermeister.
Anyway, the Warhol soup cans and the Coke bottles are really divided people when it came out. Some saw it and said it was an indictment of our consumer culture. Other people said it's an endorsement of commercialism. Warhol refused to comment. He would just say cryptic stuff and people would be all confused. They would say things like, I like candy. She's over there. She's really a man. I'm wearing a wig. I'm not really Andy Warhol, I don't think. I'm sort of a kind of Jack Benny James Mason thing going on. Andy Warhol was so famous and huge in the 1970s that David Bowie wrote a song about him. It was called Andy Warhol. It was Andy Warhol. It was awesome. I don't think anyone's ever written a song about me, unless you count Aerosmith's Dude Looks Like a Lady. Dude looks like a lady. An old lady that works in a store. Yeah, it didn't make the album. Anyway, look. You know what? Andy Warhol also made movies. This is true. That one movie he made was just a close-up of a guy's face while he received pleasure. I'm not allowed to say the title of the movie, is what I'm saying. It rhymes with crow job, right? That's the name of the movie. Yeah. Critics called it the feel-good movie of the year. Can you imagine? But wait. Can you imagine auditioning for that movie and then they say, well, we're not sure about you for the lead. Would you be interested in a supporting role? Absolutely not! Well, who else is in it? Remember, there are no small parts, only small actors.
In your pants.
Hey, now! Anyway, it's time now for us to take what we call a commercial break. This
break time.
Welcome back, everybody. I said something in the monologue and we had to cut it out. Of course, we could have done it again, but... That would mean I'd have to do it twice. So, shall we have a commercial break then?
Break time.
What is that gahook gahook thing you're doing? Is that a Goofy impression? Is that what it is?
Yes, sir.
Well, I, for one, don't care for it, sir.
Oh, you.
All right, we have to... We have to take a break, but when we come back, it'll cost $34 million just to see me.
Intern Rehearsal Theater. Sketches on this show are not rehearsed by real people. Instead, we use unpaid interns who are expendable in case anything goes wrong.
Whoa, Stan Lee, comic book genius, master of Marvel, personal friend of mine. Great to see you.
All right, Craig, what do you want?
Want? I don't want anything.
Intern Rehearsal Theater.
Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to the show tonight, which has been rehearsed and in no way edited. You're looking at a man who's hanging on to his job by this much. And you're also looking at a man that doesn't give a rat's ass by this much.
You the man.
Hey! What time is it, Jeffrey Peterson?
Shake your bag and grab some tweets.
I can't do both. You'll have to pick one. I'll grab some tweets.
Tweet, tweet, tweet. Twitter. Chicken Vindaloo is good to eat. My name is Scooter. I'll fix your computer. I'm a happening guy and a dope troubleshooter. When you call tech support, you'll be talking to me. I got more patience than Mahatma Gandhi. And emails.
And emails. Who's at the door? I'm not going to stop it until you stop asking me to stop it. All right, we got the tweets and the emails. Let's see. This is from Scott in Knoxville, Tennessee. Scott says, Dear Craig, my friend Kelly got offered a photographer position for a porn magazine. Should she take it? Really? Is that a real question? Well, maybe it would be good on her portfolio to... Yes! That's the job I'll be going for once you see the unedited version of this show. All right, this is from James in Aspen, Colorado. That's James there. He's a duck. James says, Hey, Craig. Hey, James. This is from Tim in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Tim says, Tim there. He's a flamingo. The birds of the world. That's the show I'm going to do once I get canned out of here.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. And you know what? And then you can sit here, and I'll stand over there making wise-ass comments only 8 per show.
That's my Fugermeister.
All right, this is from Tim in Fort Wayne, Indiana. He says, Craig, I'm always hearing that women have a higher pain threshold than men. Do you think it's true? Well, I know it's true, Tim. And even if it wasn't true, I'd be on the side of women. Why? Why do you think? They do, though. Women do have a pain threshold higher than men. It's true. Because they're having babies. Like, if men had babies, there wouldn't be anybody. We'd be like, you know what? I'm going, I'm good. Somebody's got to have a baby. Well, not me, buddy. All right. This is from Bailey in California. California, Missouri? There's a California in Missouri? I wonder if it's better than this one. That's where I'll be going after I get. He says, Dear Craig, I am a twin and we are both tired of our jobs. Should we switch places and see how we like each other's jobs? Should you? It's a Disney movie. I think hijinks would ensue. Wasn't that a movie with Lindsay Lohan? Didn't she do that? She changed her... I don't know. Leave her alone, Craig. Leave her alone.
All right, this is from Mike in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. I like Milwaukee. It's very nice. Right on the lake there, right on Lake Oprah. Mike says, Dear Craig, is it really cheap of me to buy next year's Halloween costume now while they're discounted? Yeah. This is from Tomislav in Rytkja in Croatia. Rytkja. It's probably not pronounced that. I look forward to your outraged pronunciation email. Tomislav says, Hi, Craig. Do you ever get annoyed with boring and pointless emails? Oh, you bet. This is from Noah in Newark, New Jersey. Noah in Newark, New Jersey? Noah in Newark, New Jersey says, Hi, Craig. I get nervous when I fly and I'm about to travel overseas. Any suggestions how to calm my nerves? Well, Noah, what about taking a boat? How about that? If you're wondering, by the way, what happened earlier on when that thing got edited out, we'll be right back, everybody! Welcome back, everybody! Welcome back! Welcome back to the completely non-edited show! My first guest tonight is on a TBS show. TBS, that's where I'm looking to go once I get... Although I think they're kind of full up now. Anyway, he's in a new TBS show. It's called Glory Days, which premieres Tuesday, November the 16th. Take a look at this.
Excuse me. Excuse me. I'm sorry. Am I not interesting enough for you? Or is this just the first time you sat next to a girl?
Yes. No, I mean, no. I mean, yes, you are interesting. But no, this is not the first time I sat next to a girl. I sit next to lots of girls. I love it.
That's good. Because from the looks of it, this may be the only thing you do with a girl your whole college career. Burn.
Please welcome my friend Tim Meadows, everyone. Tim, you look awesome. You looked really awesome.
Thank you, sir.
I wanted to say this is the same outfit I had on last time I was on your show.
Is it really?
Yeah, so I don't have a lot of clothes. You look sad all of a sudden.
Well, you came on here with your hard luck tail. All right. There you go.
Thank you. All
right. Wow. Now, aren't you glad you got here a little bit late? Because that little sketch at the beginning with Stan Lee,
yeah.
You were meant to be the naked guy in that.
Yeah.
That's true. That's true. And Tim was late. And so
I could still get naked if you want.
What? No.
No, don't do that. Right. I'm already in enough trouble. I mentioned something tonight that we'll never know about. I got edited. Tell me about the Glory Days show. What's that about then?
Well, Glory Days is a show based...
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I don't know if that's going to work.
Well, we'll see. No, it's set in the 80s in Indiana at a college. And I play a college professor, a very angry, liberal... political scientist, I guess would be the phrase.
Political scientist?
Yeah. You know, I guess he takes politics and makes
turns. Yeah.
Yeah.
Or maybe he makes creatures that eventually take over Washington.
Maybe Glenn Beck.
Are you the crotchety old one? Hey, no. Do you remember are you the crotchety old guy and all the rest of the actors are young ones?
Yeah, you know, it's a trip because it's the first show that I've been on where I'm the...
I got a mouse. Who's that?
If that robot is going to come alive...
Yeah, no, it's all right.
Screwing.
What was that? Someone broke wind? What?
It sounded like a robot farted.
It sounded like...
In your pants.
Yeah.
How can he be funnier than me?
He's funnier than all of us. It's digital technology. It's the new way of comedy. Soon, all comedy will be able... You'll just be able to go to the supermarket and buy some comedy, take it home, plug it into the wall. Mm. And
just watch it, comedy.
Just watch some comedy, and you won't need us.
Yeah. Right now is happening.
Yeah, right now it's happening. Right there.
What were we talking about?
I don't know. Let's edit this out, too.
Can you edit out a whole show?
Yeah, sure, really? Easily. Yes, you can edit out everything. It's the way of the future. You'll be able to go to the supermarket and edit out your entire trip to the supermarket.
Why do you go to the supermarket to do everything in your story? In your future, everything happens at the supermarket.
Because that's what guys do when they're trying to sell you stuff. And these, in the future, you'll be able to go to the supermarket and get a rocket car, which you can edit out of your... Do you have a rocket car?
Not yet, no.
I see.
Yeah.
If you went to my supermarket, you'd have one.
I want to go to your future supermarket.
Yeah,
it sounds great.
Are you shooting this show here or in Chicago? Are you in Chicago?
Well, it's actually here. I am in Chicago half the time. But
you should get a rocket car then. It'd be Chicago here, Chicago.
I wish I was like 20 years from now. I wish that I could get a rocket car.
20 years from now, you'd be able to go to your supermarket in both Chicago and Los Angeles.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. So you're bi-curious then?
Yes, I'm bi-curious. But yeah, I'm there, and I'm actually shooting in... I'm just gonna keep going. I'm shooting in Pasadena, which is literally like being in another friggin' state, you know.
Pasadena?
Yeah.
There was that song about Pasadena. Little old lady from Pasadena, she goes to the supermarket, gets a rocket car. You know that song? That's a great song.
It is. You've lost your mind.
Yeah.
Totally lost it. I read your book. I wanted to tell you, I read your book.
What, a book I had or I wrote?
Yeah.
Kilt.
Yeah. Yes.
What did you call it, a skilt?
I called them Skittles, yeah.
Skittles,
whatever.
Oh, I had Skittles, but you couldn't see them.
Yes. But I loved your book.
Thanks very much, indeed.
Yeah. I read it, like, I kept seeing it in my apartment, and I was like, I really should read it, because when I see you again, it would be rude to not be able to say I read your book.
Well, I wouldn't have brought it up.
You would not have?
No, but now there's a quiz.
Great. Ask me anything about you. I can answer any question about you that's in that book.
All right. Which supermarket do I go to?
I don't remember that was in there.
Right, so, you know then that I had a very difficult time in the 1980s when your show was short. Now,
I did.
You were famously out of your mind for the entire 1980s as well,
Yes. I was going to say that I could literally scratch... I could use your biography as my own biography because...
No, you can't do that. That's against the law.
Really?
Yeah.
I could just, like, scratch out your name, put my name. Instead of Scotland, I could just put Detroit. It's the same thing.
Actually, I've been to Detroit. You're not far wrong. Yeah.
Same thing. I played in a band, like, after high school. Instead of you play drums, I played saxophone.
Saxophone's a bit cooler.
It is. I did get
it. Yeah, it's a little more kind of,
Yeah. It's like, you can, like, charm a woman in the bed playing saxophone. Like a snake, you know? Like
It's like a snake charm. Like, women... They can famously deal with a lot of pain, but saxophones render they're like kryptonite. Yeah, and let me say another thing about the feminist movement.
I'm yours.
Let me forget my principles. A saxophone has made me a slut. No, but the ladies do like a saxophone player.
The
drummers
do.
Are just like, oh, come on, really?
You know. Well, you know, I don't know. I think women like drummers, too.
Well, some women, you know, and by women, I mean men.
I think it's the muscles that, you know, you get as a drummer.
I drummed a lot, and all it did is it kind of kept my weight down a bit, which was good because I was the only person I knew that could take cocaine and then want pizza.
Why would you?
I don't know. It's just it happens to me. I'm crazy. It's almost like I'd gone to the supermarket.
No, usually, like, when you smoke pot, that's when you get the munchies and you eat pizza. Yeah. I think most people... Well, don't cheer.
This is news to you.
I wouldn't know.
Yeah, no, but I've heard that rumor myself. Yeah.
Can I have some more money while I'm sitting here?
Yeah, sure. How much do you want?
$20 would be great.
Oh, no, you can't have that. Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
Well, that's 19. Oh, no, I already gave you one.
Oh, yeah, okay. So I got 20 then.
Yeah, you're good. Yeah, yeah.
Is this here for any specific reason?
Yes, it is exactly. There is a very good reason. If I have a difficult guest, someone who doesn't want to answer my questions, mm-hmm. I'm like, this refresh your memory? I got it from a cop show. I saw this cop show. I thought, they always bribe people, and then they remember.
Uh-oh.
So I think, well,
A dollar, I don't know if that's really going to do it, though. You know, you need maybe get some 20s out here. This is professional show business, isn't it?
No, it is not.
What am I doing here?
You know, fill in your time, man. Yeah. Fill in your time. Just like me. Waiting to get fired.
I almost came out here to get fired today because I was going to complain because I was late. I was going to be in that videotape.
Right.
And I was in Pasadena and I was supposed to, they said to me, oh, you're going to leave here at 3:30.
Right.
And I was like, no, I was supposed to be at CVS at 3:30.
Oh.
Unless you got some kind of machine that can, where can I get it?
A rocket car. The supermarket in Pasadena. The little old lady from Pasadena. They got a rocket car and came over the hill.
Yeah.
We're out of time. We're out of time. We're done.
Oh. Dippity doop.
Yeah.
I don't know what
dippity
that means.
Dippity doop, that kind of rhymes with soup, doesn't it?
Yeah.
My man, you're good.
Yeah.
This is I got something for you. Wait.
Well, I was giving you a free mouth organ.
I brought this for you from Washington.
You did?
Yeah, that's for you.
Oh, thank you.
I asked him what was
I really love this. Thank you so much. Look, it's the First Ladies of the United States flashcard.
Yeah. I said, what's the slowest selling thing you got?
Oh, and it starts with Martha.
Yes,
yeah.
That's right.
Back to the show. My next guest is the chairman of POW Entertainment and the chairman emeritus of that. I think that means he's got a very small car. Chairman emeritus of Marvel Entertainment. His new book is called Stan Lee's How to Draw Comics. This is a clue to who he actually is. Now, the book seems to be flawed because I don't see any mentions of Invisible Clothes Man. But it is in stores on November the 16th. Please welcome the legend, the American treasure that is Stan Lee, everybody. Stan Lee! Hey, Stan! How you doing? Did you think about my Invisible Clothes Man idea?
Boy, it was awful.
Yeah, it's pretty bad, yeah.
I gotta tell you, I have a number of bones to pick with you. One of them, how the hell do I get to follow a comedian? I mean, that act was so good. Everybody was laughing. Look, I've been on 30 seconds, not a laugh yet. And on top of that, you have him on first. When you're full of energy and spirit and fun and everything, now you're exhausted. I have to carry the whole show. I mean, look at you. You're worn out. It isn't fair, it isn't right.
You're right.
And I have another idea.
Yeah, what?
I've been watching the robot skeleton.
Yeah, Jeff Peterson. It's good.
That you know, would be Jeff. Jeff.
Yeah.
I call him Jeff.
Okay.
It seems to me, have you ever thought of letting Jeff be the host and you be the straight man?
Yes, yes.
I mean, he's got the personality.
Yes,
there you go.
No,
he could do it. That, I said that very thing tonight. Once I get
Tootsie
canned, he can have this job.
Yeah, there you go.
And then he can do the like that, and I'll be over there making.
And he'd probably let me come on first.
Yeah, I'm sure
when
he would.
All
yes, sir.
Well, fine. Well, look, why don't the two of you just get your own talk show then?
Stan, what about Skelly Man?
That sturdy man.
Skelly Man. I think he's
Skelly Man.
Skelly Man. Yeah, he's trying.
Is
to,
he referring to me or to
no,
you?
No, he's not talking about you.
Well, you never know.
No,
hey,
no.
Don't keep thumbing that. We may want to sell it to somebody.
No, I'm looking.
Keep it pristine.
If I had a nickel for every time I'd heard that sentence.
Don't speak of your nickels. Did I see you giving money to people?
How much do you want?
Is this my fee for being on the show?
You bet it is.
$2? How about $3?
$3, all right. $3.
All right. I don't have to give it back after it's over,
no,
do
no,
I?
No, it's genuinely...
I can really keep this?
Yeah, all right.
Did Tim keep it?
Yeah.
Really? How much did you give him?
$20.
Well, come on. You're a witness, he said I could keep it.
Yeah, no, you can't keep it.
All right.
You want an elastic
band?
All right, okay, good.
You'll be able to want the rubber band back.
Yeah, you can take that and use it to, you know, because I know you're poor, Stan, you know.
Did you, well, I don't work for Network.
Yeah.
Did you read every bit of this?
Oh, yeah.
Can I ask you questions about it?
Sure, right.
Really? How do you, when you letter a strip, how do you arrange where the balloons go, in what order, and how do you sort of paginate everything?
You do it carefully.
I can see why you're the host.
That's right. No, this is fascinating. My son is fascinated by this, by your work, and I'm going to give him that. But this drawing of you on the front, this
doesn't
is you.
Doesn't do me justice.
No, I was going to say it's...
No. Well, what drawing could? I mean, a drawing is just a quiet, still, inanimate thing.
You're right.
You can't give the drawing personality and verve and wit and all of that, can you?
Did you draw this?
No, I don't draw that well. I do great stick
figures. You do
figures.
The design, right? You edit.
No, I didn't even design it. No, I said, hey, somebody draw me a cover, and that's what happened. That's the way it works.
Really?
I'm a busy man. Yes.
Well, what the hell do you do? You just have other people do your stuff, and then you're on Twitter all the
time.
That's right. You're always on the Twitter.
You know, speaking of the Twitter.
Oh, yeah.
I understand that you have more followers than I have brigadiers. See, we call our people brigadiers. You have followers.
Followers are called the Robot Skeleton Army.
Yeah, but you only have one. I haven't seen any other skeletons, but I'll bet in your audience I have a lot of brigadiers. I'll bet that. Yeah. Would the brigadiers please applaud? And we haven't rehearsed it.
How the hell did you do that?
I know it just
happens. You're a genius.
Wherever I go, my brigadiers are there to protect me and to guide me. And you know what we're doing? We're making up little dog tags for our brigadiers.
Oh, boy, no, I'm scared.
That we can sell at a big profit. And we're forming our own nation.
You're forming your own nation?
Our own nation.
Well, what is it going to be called then? Brigadieria?
No.
Because that sounds like a skin condition.
You know, you're not good at names. You're not good at making up superheroes either.
What are you talking about? Jeff Peterson, that's a great name for a superhero.
Every superhero needs a sidekick.
He is better than what you tried to make up earlier today. I mean,
the invisible clothes man.
I mean, what got into you there? You know, I think I should be on staff here to guide you,
to help you. You
shouldn't be allowed to flounder alone the way you do.
Oh! Will you please tell CBS that? Could you tell them that? Because I can't even cuss here, Stan. I can't even cuss. And when I mention certain things that are involved with certain sponsors, I find myself edited.
My brigadiers will write letters to CBS. That would be more effective than just me doing it.
Do these people do your bidding?
Of course. I'm their generalissimo. Where have you been? I mean, don't you get out there? Don't you find out what's happening in the world? Or are you confined to this little... And another thing about this desk. Why do you always sit higher than your guest? Have you noticed that? You're always a little bit higher.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
absolutely. Well, there's a reason for that. my ooh la la Joe. I tell you, the honest truth about that, I don't know, but when I started the show, they said, why do I sit up higher? They said, that's how you do late night.
I know you
watch all the other shows. It's true. They all sit like, yeah, how you doing? And it's like, you see giant guys who are like, what the hell? And like, whoa, over them.
I must confess.
What?
You're quicker than I am.
No,
no, you are. I love this guy.
No.
You are really. You are my favorite
what are you
guy.
Up to?
You know, you yeah. really. Someday, I hope you get your own show.
You
I
get
really
my own
do.
Show. No,
I hope
no,
you do.
It'll never happen. It'll never happen. Are you still in the business of making more superheroes, or do you think we have enough?
Yeah. Well, I have this little company called POW Entertainment.
Right. Okay.
And of course, that stands for Purveyors of Wonder. POW.
Right.
You'll
right.
work it out.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
And we do movies and television and DVDs and publishing and comics and everything.
Right.
So you can't get bored. The minute one thing bores you, you do something else. Like you on your show. You get a guest like me, you get rid of me fast and you'll get somebody else. And it keeps you going, you know.
No, I would keep you forever, Stan.
I'm yours. Okay, I'll be here tomorrow night.
Okay,
so
great.
What?
Yeah.
Do I get the same 20? Hey, wait a minute, you still have money there.
Yeah, no.
I thought you gave
this
it all
to me. This is in case of emergencies, in case I need another guest quickly. Emergencies.
You always talk funny.
Yes, I'm from a different country originally. How dare you?
You know, my wife is a Geordie. Do you know what
your
a Geordie
wife?
Is?
Yes, from Newcastle in the north of England.
She does the greatest Scotch accent and Geordie accent.
I can
everything.
Do a Geordie accent.
Go ahead, let me hear you.
How do we you should then. That's data.
How are you getting on, you booger?
How do we unshake this, Stan?
You're better. You're as good as she is. I can't say you're better than she is, or we will go.
No,
home
no,
tonight.
I understand. Yeah, yeah. Did all your right, wife anyway. Watch the show then?
Pardon me?
Only when you were on it, right?
That's right.
Yeah,
now,
yeah,
we should get serious because
oh, really?
People. No, when people learn I'm going to be on a show, they expect some things. They expect some erudition. They expect some scholarly things.
Not here, forth. They don't, buddy. No, no, no. No, what they expect is they expect that you're probably plugging something, so you're willing to appear on this show when you wouldn't normally do that.
Well, I don't plug anything.
All right, Stanley!
You don't call that a plug. I mean, this thing won't even sit in the bookstores. It's probably all sold out by now. This doesn't need plug, especially after it's been on your show.
Yeah,
my
there you
God.
Go. Yeah.
You know the enthusiasm your fans have for anything that you hold up. Maybe I shouldn't rephrase that.
Yeah, you should rephrase it. Stan, we're out of time. It's always a pleasure to see you. Will you come back? And now it's been very long.
Tomorrow.
Time. Okay, tomorrow. Join me tomorrow with Stan Lee, everybody. We'll be right back.
If you're watching Craig at home, you're missing half the fun. Consider this your formal invitation to laugh live in our studio audience at a taping of The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson. Please give us a call at 323-570-0059 or visit our website at oneiota.com.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Craig?
Oh, my. Do you know what I learned on the show? Like, both Tim and Stan tonight both asked for money. And I think word is getting around in the celebrity community that there's bucks to be made on this show. Really. And so the ones that really need money are turning up.
In your pants.
I don't want people just to come here for money. I want them to come here because they want to come here. Like me. Listen, if the show in any way looked edited tonight, it's because I said something irresponsible and wrong. And I promise not to say it again. Good night, everybody.